live, Jimmy?
We're live. And then I gotta...
You need to use your clip there. Hey, everybody. I can't, Yeah, you go in that and get that going.
Marina's live.
Yeah, there's the time, like, to turn the volume down.
All right, there's two people.
So we're just getting ready to do this jam, everyone. Get tuned up. It looks a little different this week because my buddy Jamie Dufour, longtime friend who I'm in Painkiller Jane with, has joined me. And we're gonna play a whole bunch of stuff for you. It's Black Sabbath night.
Margaret is watching. Hi, Margaret.
Thinking of my Black Sabbath repertoire. General is gathered. Never mind. So, we're going to do a whole bunch of Beatles songs tonight, everyone. Sarah. Never mind, I'll do it. I want to get a little rock. So that we can tip our phone up, Jamie, will you tip the phone up? We're doing our best to social distance here and be responsible. Hope you can appreciate it. It ain't gonna be perfect. It's, nothing's gonna be absolutely perfect. We're gonna play a bunch of Beatles songs tonight. We played about two Beatles songs together about 2 weeks ago, and now we have a whole bunch more than that, so they're all kind of new to us, and we're gonna enjoy it. I'm on the job site brewing from Stratford.
Triple Bogey.
Triple Bogey?
Triple Bogey is from Toronto. Triple Bogey Brewing Company.
Your wife wants to know where your little shirt is.
Yeah, it's got a big hole in the armpit, so I didn't wear it. Yeah.
Alright. Alright, let's see how we do.
Anything about the first song that you want to, any history? Hey, there's a chipmunk.
Chipmunk? Oh, we should have Charlie out here too. We have a dog. If we had a dog, we wouldn't have a chipmunk.
Okay, you ready?
Piney, how you doing? Wayne? All right.
Oh, Steven for Billy.
Hey, Steven, how you doing? Here goes nothing.
One, two, three, four.
Help! I need somebody.
Help!
Anybody.
Help!
You know I need someone.
Help! When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way. But now those days are gone, I'm not so self-assured.
And now I find,
changed my mind,
opened up the door.
Help me if you can, I'm feeling down, and I do appreciate you being around.
Help me get my feet back on the ground.
Won't you please, please help me?
Now,
and now my life has changed in oh so many ways.
My independence
seems to vanish in the haze.
Now,
but every now and then
now,
I feel so insecure.
I know that I've
changed a life I never have done before.
Back on the ground.
Won't you please, please help me? When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's
help in any way.
But now those days are gone, I'm not so self-assured.
But now I find,
changed my mind,
opened up the door.
Help me if you can.
Get my feet back on the ground.
Won't you please, please help me?
Help me, help me.
Thank you very much. We will be reading off the pages tonight. It's kind of unavoidable learning so many new songs all at once.
Okay.
Also, probably won't be responding as much because the phone's over there and it's just a little bit hard to see. But John Sutcliffe's on.
John
Sutcliffe. Hey, buddy. Long time.
So I read something pretty cool today. Did you know that there was a fifth Beatle named Stuart Sutcliffe who was a bass player?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it was John and Steve's uncle from Liverpool.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Should we talk in English accents?
Well, he's dead, but...
Oh, well, we won't talk to him then. I played with a fifth Beatle named Pete Best, who was the drummer. I didn't play with him. We did sound for him.
Yeah.
Interesting story.
Nice guy.
Halliburton, Ontario. All right. This happened once before. I came to your door. No reply. They said it wasn't you, but I saw you peek through your window. I saw the light. I saw the light. I know that you saw me, but I looked up to see your face. I tried to telephone. They said you were not home. That's a lie. It is a C added ninth. For any guitar players and musicians out there, as you know, the Beatles are weird. Their chords, like, that's the only song in my life I ever played a C added ninth to. And then there's an A major minor seventh, whatever the heck that means, which is like this thing. And nobody does that stuff except for the Beatles. And this one, they're just strange.
It's pretty tough for a drummer.
Yeah. So, cheers to awesome, awesome weather, everyone. I usually go through one beer in one of these sessions. I got Jimmy beside me, so I'm encouraged to try to beat that a little bit tonight.
Well, and there's a couple songs I don't play, so I get some breaks.
And you can go get me a beer, you mean?
I can go get you a
beer. Thank you, yes, sir. Thank you. All right. We're going to pause a little bit before each song, just like, say we don't know them all.
Aaron's watching. Hi, Aaron.
Oh, yeah.
Hi,
Janet.
This is Mark's Facebook feed, so some of these people I don't know.
You know Margaret?
I know Margaret.
Oh, I can't see the list down there. I sing this one. Here I stand, head in hand, turn my face to the wall. If she's gone, I can't go.
Hide your love away. Hey, you got to hide your love away. got to hide your love away.
Interesting thing, we started off, for anyone who missed the first song was Help. Interesting tidbit about Help was that it was in a movie, and the single Help, when it first came out, it was going to be in a movie, which you know is the movie Help, which is a famous movie. But at that time, the movie was called Eight Arms to Hold You. And the single was released as the song for this new movie, Eight Arms to Hold You, which was the Beatles movie Help. And then they changed the movie name. So, little known fact, it was the Memorial Day weekend, and SiriusXM's Beatles channel played the top 100 all weekend long, again and again and again. So I heard lots of facts and listened to lots of Beatles.
Like you hadn't already.
Like I hadn't already.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy, I lost the flip flop.
Move this a bit so I can see our set list a bit, Jimmy. Good.
Okay.
This was their first album. This is their third single and first number one hit in the UK. Your comments right now.
Oh yeah, we can.
Can
you? Yeah, yeah.
You've freshed in or something?
Lori Mitchell says hello.
Hello, Lori.
Hi, Lori.
Cheers. All right.
Any history on this song?
I don't have any history on this song. Beatles wrote a lot of love songs, obviously, and some of them weren't Shakespeare, but they all worked really well. When I asked Jamie about doing this, I looked up how many Beatles songs there were. There were like 190-something original Beatles songs and then a pile of covers, like Twist and Shout, for example, is a cover. And James said, yeah, I'd love to do it. And I shortlisted, I think, 96 songs. And out of them, we picked about, I think we're going to play about 24 or 25, something in that range.
Did you know it was my anniversary today?
Oh yeah!
Happy anniversary!
Oh yeah, happy anniversary!
Carrie reminded me this morning. I knew it was coming. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, you bet.
Yeah, so we've been together for 25 years.
26.
25 this year?
26 years.
Oh no, okay, 26.
Married for 15.
Well, this is not the right song to play.
This is not. This has nothing to do with my anniversary.
Yeah. But, I'm just gonna check this phone. It just did something.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I'm not connected to your Wi-Fi.
Oh, you're not connected to my Wi-Fi. Yeah. Okay, so it's probably trying.
So
to.
If yeah, is there is the feed good, guys? Is yeah, because I'm going over cellular. You guys are good. Well, we'll just let it go then.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, we got this is one we got to think about, Jamie, because it goes all over the place.
Okay.
Okay. Not an anniversary song. That'll come later on. You're gonna lose that girl.
Yes, yes, you're gonna lose that girl.
You're gonna lose that girl.
Yes, yes, you're gonna lose that girl.
If you don't take her out tonight, you're gonna change her
She's
mind.
She's gonna change her mind.
And I will take her out tonight, and I will make her
I'm
mine.
I'm gonna treat her kind.
You're gonna lose that
yes,
girl.
Yes, yes, you're gonna lose that girl.
You're gonna lose
yes, yes, you're
that,
gonna
girl.
Lose that girl.
If you don't treat her right, my friend, you're gonna find her
you're
gone.
You're gonna find her gone.
Cause I will treat her right, and then you'll be the lonely
you're
one.
You're the only one.
You're gonna lose that
yes,
girl.
Yes,
because we've messed that one up a pile of times. It's all good.
This is one of those songs that's on two pages but should be on six, because you finish a course and it says do verse one, and then you finish verse one, it says go to verse three, and
yeah,
you're jumping all over two pages anyway.
Yeah. Hi, Carrie McRae, how you doing, kiddo? Nick, Anna, how you doing? Beth, Millie's exhausted from being outside today. Oh yeah, hot. God.
Why would anybody want to be outside today?
I was outside today. The boat, the lake, the beach.
Went in the water.
Damn straight.
I guess those are good reasons.
The water's, the water's a world nicer than it was 2 days ago. 2 days ago it was bone chilling, and today it was just fine.
I wonder, is Dan Greenwood on there? Dan was in the water, in the river, 3 days ago.
Was he?
Yeah.
The river would be cool.
Yeah, I watched him fall in when he was trying to put his boat on his trailer.
I heard about this. There you go, Danny. Danny caught a big salmon today, though.
Mm.
Saw that.
He's going to smoke it and give us some. I'm sure.
Okay, we're going to try to keep this one slow, Jimmy. All
right. Play the beginning.
Oh, you want me to play the beginning?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today. Yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She don't care. ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. Should've think twice, should've do right by me before she gets to saying goodbye. Should've think twice, should've do right by me. I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today, yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride, but she don't care. I don't know why she's riding so high. Should've been twice, should've do right by me before she gets to saying goodbye. Should've been twice, should've do right by me. Said that living with me is bringing her down, yeah. She would never be free when I was around. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She don't care. My baby don't care. My baby don't care. My baby don't care. My baby don't care.
That's our fade out. Thanks, everybody.
Hey, there's neighbors on the lawn.
In case you're wondering, not many neighbors, and there's two houses.
No, they're on their
here,
own
so
lawn.
They're on their own lawn. That's perfectly fine. Lisa and Owen, hi, guys.
Oh, perfect.
I forgot what I was going to say now, but...
This was the last call, this next song, right? You weren't going to do it.
Yeah, we didn't know if we were going to play this one or not. So, in case anyone's wondering, I'm Mark Moran. This is Jamie Dufour. We're in Brights Grove, Ontario. Jamie and I play in a band called Painkiller Jane together. This is the 8th Tuesday. I've been doing this Tuesday night. First time with a friend, first time outside. It's absolutely wonderful. It's a great feeling. Yeah.
Home of Mike Weir.
Home of Mike Weir.
And Jeff Draves.
And Jeff Draves, who happens to be in my front yard right now.
Not quite close enough to the curb.
We are being responsible.
Always.
All right.
You ready?
Yeah.
A one.
Love, love me do. You know I love you. I'll always be true. So please, love me do. Thank you.
think I sang it differently last time too, but
oh well, we'll take it.
Oh well, I gotta go get something. I meant to bring out earlier on. I'll be right back.
Is it my Jamie, early birthday gift?
Jamie, just keep amused.
No, if you leave me by myself, I don't know what to do. I'm just gonna stare at the camera. All right, let's see who's here. Okay, somebody say something. Beth Moran, hi Beth. It's turning into a Tuesday tradition. It sure is. Kevin, hey, Fexy, how you doing?
Kevin said something about elbows looking like 5.5 inch. What's that mean?
I don't know.
You guys explain that to me. What's that mean?
What's that? I missed it.
Hey, Trev.
Oh,
Pete.
Distance, right.
Thanks for the
distance.
Music stand, Pete. Carla, how you doing?
We've been using this stuff a lot. We've been very, very safe in this
Steve
production.
Steve Sutcliffe, that's Stuart Sutcliffe's nephew, is on. Smitty, how you doing?
Pete is the other guy in our band. Pete Michelli,
Dave Connors, how you doing,
as well
Dave?
As Heather Wellington.
Tracy Arnold. Trace, how you doing? I'm just going through the people that I know. Tammy Martin, also known as Tammy Wichtra.
Hello, buddy.
Rita, how you doing, Rita? My cousin Dina from London.
You got a whole pile of new
Ross
people
Felton.
Watching. Got Jamie's people.
Oh, you have way more friends than me.
Should have done this like a month ago.
Fergie.
But we couldn't be inside. That was the tricky part. Meg, would you do me a favor and go grab me another job site from Stratford, Ontario?
Heather McAlpine.
Published Day Tripping Magazine. That's one of my customers. Great beer.
Lena.
Great people.
How you doing? Kev. Moore.
That's in the
What's
beer.
Up? Fridge. Scott Maneri. How you doing, Scott? Thanks for keeping me going Saturday nights.
Saw you, Scotty. Scotty got a spinny chair. They're great, aren't they, buddy?
Don Quackenbush, how you doing, Don? Schmidt, how was your victory buffet?
You know, while I'm on the topic, an interesting thing about this is that this whole virus quarantine thing is that in some cases, I think like I've gotten to know some people better than I knew them before through chats, through being like-minded in their approach to this whole quarantine and all that. And Scott Maneri is one of those because I've commented about Scotty a whole pile of times on my thing here. If Scotty hadn't done it a couple weeks before I did, I don't know if I would have, but he did. And it looked like a great fun time and he led by example. So cheers to you, buddy. But in reality, I've met Scott Maneri like twice. Now, I can't wait to see him after this because we got a hell of a lot to talk about.
And he used the swivel chair Saturday night.
He used the swivel chair.
He mentioned you.
And these ones kind of swivel. Not as much as the one in there. So, I brought these things up. This is a song from my niece, Beth. Her dad is my brother, Steve, and he passed away a few years ago. I told the story before, but his go-to song on guitar was Rocky Raccoon by the Beatles. And he always played it with a thumb pick, and I was just a kid, and I thought you had to play it with a thumb pick. I thought that was like part of doing it, so I always wanted to learn how to use the thumb pick. In reality, it's because he had chopped his thumb off in half working on construction. There was a crane with a bunch of pipes coming down, and he was moving them around, and they shifted. They squeezed his thumb clear off, leaving half of it there. And my brother-in-law, Bruce, was with them at the time on the construction site. But Steve had to drive himself to the hospital because Bruce was too grossed out to drive. But this is a song that is called, obviously, Rocky Raccoon. Somewhere in the Black Mountain Hills, Dakota, there lived a young boy named Rocky Raccoon. Well, one day his woman ran off with another guy. Hit young Rocky in the eye. Rocky didn't like that. Said, I'm gonna get that boy. So one day he walked into town, booked himself a room at the local saloon. Rocky Raccoon checked into his room, only to find Gideon's Bible. Rocky had come equipped with a gun to shoot off the leg of his rival. His rival, it seems, had broken his dreams by stealing the girl of his fancy. Her name was McGill, but she called herself Lil. But everyone knew her as Nancy. Now she and her man, who called himself Dan, were in the next room at the hoedown. Rocky burst in and grinning a grin, said, "Danny boy, this is a showdown." But Daniel was hard, he drew first and shot, and Rocky collapsed in the corner. La la da 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 da. The doctor came in, stinking of gin, proceeded to lie on the table. Said, "Rocky, you met your match." Rocky said, "Doc, it's only a scratch. And I'll be better, Doc, I'll be better as soon as I am able." Now Rocky Raccoon fell back in his room, only to find Gideon's Bible. Gideon checked out and left in no doubt to prepare for good Rocky's revival.
Good job, Mark.
That's a good song. Love that song.
That Rocky Raccoon.
This is an interesting one because Scotty's still listening to any musicians, or any singers anyway. I sang since the time I was, since I could talk, and every report card ever said was basically, "Mark is a good student, but he sings too much in class." And it was, I'm sure it was true. But Colleen is in my front yard. There are a couple people in my front yard. But Colleen, you're a singer. And if you're singing the Beatles songs, you sing harmonies where there aren't harmonies. Because you've heard them so many times, and sometimes there's harmonies and sometimes there aren't harmonies, and you don't really remember where they are and where they aren't. So this is a song, it's "Can't Buy Me Love." The song has no harmonies.
Until
in
now.
In the recording. But I can't imagine doing the song without harmonies. So now it has harmonies. And we're gonna sing every other line. Just for the heck of it. Cheers again.
Ready? Take your time. We're not getting paid for this, so.
We're not? Whatever a G13th is. There's a G13th. You know how stupid that is? That is a... You can play it like this.
One, two, three, four. You need,
or you
six...
can just play a G.
No, it says you need six fingers.
Oh, see, G13th is like this. Nobody does that. Sounds the same to me, just do a G.
Ready?
Yep.
A one, two, three. Can't buy me love. Love. Can't buy. I don't care.
we're supposed to do it slow, but and then the C7th there is like C7, but really it should be like a C7 and a C added ninth, I think. But well, that's just picking at straws, isn't it?
You have a drummer with you, remember?
Yeah, Jamie's our drummer in Painkiller Jane. So people who haven't seen Painkiller Jane,
C7th is like
Jamie's the
for
drummer.
A drummer. That's like
really easy. It's like you go
triple paradiddle,
whack, whack. So Painkiller Jane, by the way, most of our summer gigs are gone, obviously. The Duke cruises in June are gone for sure. We haven't heard about July and September yet, but don't know what to hold out hope for. We were going to be playing Canada Day Fireworks in Sarnia. That's gone. We were going to be celebrating the 60th anniversary of the Oil Museum, I believe it is, and that's gone by the wayside. However, we have a Facebook page for Painkiller Jane. Please join. We're at 890 members right now. When I go in tonight, I sure hope there are 900 members. And that's how you can find out about the band in general playing. And we would love, if you love seeing us play, we'd love to have you there. It's a great band. We have a bunch of fun. We have a great bunch of people come see us. And
we got some British Columbia representing.
Tar, Nicole?
No, Nicole and Jim.
Cheers, guys.
I think we have some Nova Scotia here somewhere, too.
See, Jimmy brings people to the table.
All my 7 friends are here.
How many people we have on?
62, not bad.
Beautiful Tuesday night. Twice what it was last week on a beautiful Tuesday night. And last week I sucked. Oh, I was off. Hi to my family down in Portland. I got a cool story to tell you. My sister Sue. On the day that, not the day John Lennon was killed, but the Sunday afterward, my sister Sue was moving apartments in Portlampton, Ontario. And I think you were moving into the Washington Arms, Sue, if I'm correct. Right around there anyway. And that was a Sunday afternoon when they had all the radio stations in the world went silent at 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I don't remember, for 1 or 2 minutes to honor John Lennon. And I remember being, you know, not too young, teenager. Just kind of overwhelmed that every radio station went silent for John Lennon. And I don't know how much of a Beatles fan I was at that time, but I'm a massive one now. So, little fact there.
Rob Taylor, how you doing? Another one of my friends, sorry.
Are you playing harmonica to this one?
Yeah.
Right on.
Oh, man, this is my shining harmonica song.
Oh, yeah. All right, good luck with that.
I just played it up.
Hey, you put the pressure on yourself, man. And do I sing this whole thing?
You sing it all.
Whoa, whoa, I should've known better with a girl like you, that I would love everything that you do, and I do, hey, 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 and I do, whoa, whoa, I never realized what a kiss could be, that this would only happen to me, can't you see? Can't you see that when I tell you that I love you, oh, you're gonna say you love me too, oh, and when I ask you to be mine, you're gonna say you love me too. That when I tell you that I
That'll be all the harmonica you'll hear out of me tonight.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
So this Abbey Road, shouldn't have to hold it closer, I'm sure you probably know, but awesome Beatles album. Second best album of all time, in my humble opinion. And the reason I'm bringing that up is because there's a band called Classic Albums Live that plays a lot of smaller theaters in Canada and Ontario particularly, including the Imperial Theatre in Sarnia. And if you ever get a chance to see them, definitely do it. Again, Classic Albums Live. They basically play a classic album, whether that's The Wall or Dark Side of the Moon or Breakfast in America, things like that. To a T. So they don't try to look like the band, but they play it so you close your eyes and you can barely tell that it's not the album being played. They bring in as many people as they need to do it. It's different people on stage, so it's not always the same band, more like an orchestra. And it's if you love classic rock, you will absolutely love this band, and I encourage you to see it. Imperial Theatre, downtown Sarnia, absolutely wonderful venue. Brian Austin's doing an awesome job there. And unfortunately, not much going on right now, but there will be someday, and can't wait for it.
Jenna, it's a poppy. Mark has one growing in his yard.
Yes. Yes. We make heroin from it, but don't tell anybody that, okay?
My sister moved into a house recently in London, and she had what she thought was a weed growing, but maybe Facebook already told her it was a poppy, but Mark's got the same thing, and he says it's a poppy. Straight from Afghanistan.
Yeah. Yeah. And yeah. My wife was looking, what? How you doing, Enya? Hello. Hey, guys. All right.
Enya has a request.
We're not going to play that. How about If I Fell? That's a nice song. We only had time to learn some songs, and Here Comes the Sun is one of the hardest ones there are, and with limited time, it's a beautiful George Harrison song, but we had to pass it by, unfortunately.
Hey, this is gonna be my anniversary song, okay?
I don't think so. This was for John Lennon's ex-wife. This one.
Okay.
There'll be another song. Don't worry, Jimmy. Don't worry, Gary. Trying to guide him down the good garden path here. This is a beautiful song, though. Interesting sound note, Steve. When Lennon and McCartney recorded this, they both faced each other into a microphone. They weren't 6 feet apart. Both sang into different sides of the microphone, did the song in one take, and then they did it again. And in the real version of this, both their vocals are completely double. So they're... Or two Pauls, there are two Johns singing this song.
With one Mark and one Jamie.
Yeah, we're going to do it. Blow those guys away. All right, I got to calm down and do this nicely. If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before, and I found that love was more than just holding hands. If I give my heart to you, I must be sure from the very start that you will love me more than her. If I trust sad if I knew love.
fell in love with you.
Beautiful song. Absolutely. We can't, yeah. You know, I haven't done one of those kicks in a long time, one of those, you know, when people first, you probably can't even see our legs, I don't know. You know, when people first got the virus or it was going around, everybody's finding different ways to say hello, no high fives, you know what I mean.
I don't remember that.
I know, yeah.
Oh, like a high five, but kick with your ankles?
Yeah, whatever that is. We play on a hockey team, and we finished our last game of the season, and we knew they were going to shut down the arenas. There's no doubt about it. In the second last week, we still did the lineup with the guys at the end of a hockey game, and there is no grosser handshake in the world than when you pull off your hockey gloves at the end of a hockey game and shake hands. Like, that's disgusting to begin with. Mind you, much less when there's a virus going around, you're all worried about it. So at the end of that one, it's like, no, gloves on. Fist bumping with the gloves on.
Jamie Dufour said, screw that, boys, I'm not doing it.
He's not doing what?
He didn't shake hands that night.
I didn't shake the hands last night.
No, the last game.
Oh, the second last one?
No, the very last game.
I didn't shake hands the last game. No, I'm smart. Did you?
I think I did. But I usually just wash my hands right after anyway. Hockey players are gross. Yeah.
How you doing, Michelli? Pete up there still?
Yeah, he's there.
I wish I could read more comments. Be a lot of fun.
Just a lot of highs.
Good. Steve Schmidt says, nice legs.
Oh, what was I supposed to say, Schmitty? He told me, he texted me earlier and he said I was supposed to say something right off the bat. Like, he wants to see you naked or something like that.
Me?
Something like that, yeah. He has a strange sense of humor, that guy. Great guy. I'm going to put on a capo. If you notice, we're not doing the leads to all the songs. I am going to try the lead to this song. But the lead in this song is In My Life. You think it's a harpsichord in the middle. I always thought it was a harpsichord in the middle. It was actually a piano played slowly and then sped up to sound like a harpsichord. And George Martin, the Beatles producer, played the piano on it.
I'm learning so much tonight.
I've learned so much in the last 24 hours looking this crap up. In the Sirius XM weekend with Peter Asher, who lives with Paul McCartney, and on Sirius XM, the Beatles channel, he likes to note every 5 minutes that he lived with Paul McCartney and tell Paul McCartney stories. And I don't blame him, because I would too.
See, if I tried one of those accents, it would sound Australian.
I was going to say, it sounded bad. That was rough. All right.
Ready?
You ever see the... never mind. Okay.
Go ahead.
Now, you ever see the Seinfeld episode where Kramer finds the set for the Merv Griffin show in the garbage and hauls it up to his apartment, and then he has the guy from Wild Kingdom come on with a hawk or something like that?
And then there's a squirrel.
The squirrel, yeah. So this is kind of like that. My neighbor hasn't called the cops yet, which is good. The other neighbor's over there having a drink, so cheers to you, sir. And Lisa. All right, we gonna play music here or what?
All right. Nice and slow.
Nice and slow.
There are places I'll remember. Still can recall some are dead and some are living. In my life, I love them all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compares with you. And these memories lose their meaning when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them in my life.
I keep going on for this one, but I want to tune up first, Jamie.
Okay.
As you can imagine, guitars change with the weather, and these guitars were indoors before this, and so it's a lot more humid and a lot warmer, and the tuning has changed a little bit. Bye, guys. Take care.
I'm going to grab another beer.
Okay, Jimmy.
Because I have some right here.
You'd think I'd talk about something, because I find it hard to stop. I really wish I could read who's all on there. I really do love doing that. I will tell you though, guys, that I'm doing it this week. I'm going to do one next week and just kind of take it easy on myself, because I'm back to work now in earnest, running day tripping and getting ready for a summer issue of day tripping. So that is starting to take a lot of my time, and I have to do that. It's important. Obviously, I'm a big small business guy supporting a small business, and that's my job, is to do everything I can to do that. So next week is going to be the last one, as far as I know, unless, you know, we go back into this. But it's also it's getting too nice outside, and you want to be outside and whatnot. I have absolutely loved doing this, and next winter I can completely see doing Tuesday night sessions again, or some night during the week that's just an off night in the dead of winter. And I think it'd be an absolute blast to do it and, you know, kind of relive this a little bit and have these connections and something to do and you guys to chat to each other on a Tuesday night. And the one thing I wouldn't want to do is take away from other musicians who are playing, because there are working musicians who count on that for their living, and as musicians we don't want to do that. But if it's Tuesday night, there's probably not much going on in the area, and that would actually give me a chance to promote what's going on, who's playing where on the weekend, if Dan Butts is at Rond, or if Bill Eldridge is at the Ops and Downs or something. And if there's no quarantine, then I could bring friends in to jam a few songs here and there real easy, and it'd be a lot of fun. So I've absolutely loved doing this, but I'm going to get too busy working, and I hope you are too, you know what I mean? Oh yeah, this one.
That's all you got to say about that?
Okay.
All right.
Here goes nothing.
I've just seen her face, I can't forget the time or place where she just met. She's just the girl for me, and I want all the world to see we met. Na 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 na. Had it been another day, I might have looked the other way, and I'd have never been aware. But as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Da 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 da. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. I have never known the likes of this. I've been alone, and I have missed things and kept out of sight. But as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Die, 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 die. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. I've just seen her face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just the girl for me, and I want all the world to see we met. Na 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 na. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes I am falling, keeps calling me back again.
Thank you for that.
Glad one of us remembered. All right. The wind's died down. We don't even need these clips maybe anymore. But just when you say that, the wind picks up, the page goes by. And as I mentioned, we knew two Beatles songs together. You're getting closer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Jeez. I'm just because I'm standing.
Rude.
My bad.
We played two songs together, Beatles songs, like 2.5 weeks ago, and now we
Pure L.
have about 24 or 25.
I can't wait to forget them all for a couple days.
Not me. Not me. I love doing this with this guy. Great guy. Great guy to play with. I've had the privilege of playing with some awesome people in my life. You're one of them. That's what Stomp and Tom would say.
Yes.
You start her up, Jimmy.
And likewise.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river with tangerine trees and marmalade skies. Somebody calls you. Answer quite slowly. A girl with kaleidoscope eyes. Cellophane flowers of yellow and green towering over your head. Look for the girl with the sun in her eyes and she's gone. Lucy in the sky. Newspaper taxis appear on the shore, waiting to take you away. Climb in the back with your head in the clouds and you're gone. Lucy in the sky with diamonds. Lucy in the sky with diamonds. Lucy in the sky. With plasticine porters with looking glass ties. Suddenly someone is there at the turnstile. The girl with kaleidoscope eyes. Lucy in the sky with diamonds. Lucy in the sky with diamonds. Lucy in the sky.
Has anyone else celebrated a wedding anniversary recently?
Oh, this is the one you're gonna.
What? Oh, my God!
This is the song you're gonna dedicate to my anniversary?
No.
We can work it out.
I know someone else in our crowd of six people who had a wedding anniversary. I just remembered that I saw it on Facebook the other day. Cheers, guys. Take care.
Thank you.
All right, let me check. Who else is here?
Oh, we have a couple more before this. That's right. So when I said that we played two Beatles songs before doing all this, one of them was one you probably maybe never heard. If there's a Beatles songs you've never heard, this would be one of them. It's called One After 909. They came up with it when they were in the early days, and it never made it to the album. Maybe a Hard Day's Night album, I'm not sure. And they put it out on the White album, I think, like, or Let It Be, way later on. And they were going for like a train chugging sound, which was popular at the time in 63 or 64. And for whatever reason, decided to put it out on Let It Be, probably because they had so much stuff in the studio, and they were a studio band by that time. And they just had all this stuff canned that they needed to get out. So even the band was almost all broken up. They're still putting out albums. That's how much stuff they had to work with. So.
Are you doing Mr. 909?
Yep.
Is it an E?
It's an A. Unless you want to do it in E?
No, I'll go with it.
That messes up though. Let me do an A. Okay. Since it's an A.
Well, my baby said, driving on one after 909. She said, move over, honey, I'm traveling on that line. She said, move over once, move over twice. Come on, baby, don't be cold as ice. She said, he's driving on the one after 909. Well, I begged her not to go, and I begged her on my bending knee. Said you're only fooling around me. She said, move over once, move over twice. Come on, baby, don't be cold as ice. My baby's driving on the one after 909. Picked up my bags, run to the station. The mailman says, you got the wrong location, yeah. Up my bags, run right home. Then I find you got the number wrong. Well, my baby's driving on the one after 909. She said, move over, honey, we're traveling on that line. She said, move over once, move over twice. Come on, baby, don't be cold as ice. My baby's driving on the one after 9-0. My baby's driving on the one after 9-0. My baby's driving on the one after 9-0-9.
Good job, Jamie.
All right, so, because I'm following my binder instead of the set list, I forgot about a couple songs that we're going to play. So, as I've been doing this every Tuesday, I've gotten the habit of playing the birthday song and calling out for people's birthdays. So there are a few birthdays I'd like to announce and celebrate. So, ones that went by on the 25th, Lisa Waller, a great old friend of mine, Brent Chamberlain, Lonnie Napper, the mayor of Plimpton, Wyoming. Lonnie, I don't know if you're watching, but happy birthday, buddy. Todd Bellin, an old high school friend of mine. And Carrie Bain, a really good friend of mine. So I hope you're watching, some of you. Coming up, Jeff Spence. Jeff's watched some of them. I have no idea who's on and who's not, but Jeff, cheers, man. Shelly Kern, who, great friend of ours, played her daughter's wedding. We're at their wedding, so you know Todd Kern, Kern Waters, Shelly married him. Awesome, awesome people. And one you don't know is a guy named Bob Klein, who, when I went on the road when I was 18 years old and started traveling across Ontario and all that, we were young punks, and Bob was a sound man from London. And so Bob came on the road with us. He had the PA and was our sound man, and we paid him to do that. But much, much, much more importantly than that, Bob taught us everything we needed to know and was a great mentor. You get really good when you're playing every single night and traveling from place to place. But you can also get in a lot of trouble, and there's a lot of things you need to learn, like not leaving your gear out on the road and going back into the place and not paying attention to it because it can get stolen. Things like that. How to wrap cords, how to take care of your gear. And I nominated Bob Klein for the London Music Hall of Fame earlier this year. I don't think they have announced who the winners are, but as a Lifetime Achievement Award, I nominated Bob Klein, and I certainly hope he makes it. So, Bob, if you are watching, or if you hear this later on, because you can replay the stuff back, cheers, buddy.
Cheers, Bob. I'm sure I probably learned a few things through you from him.
Exactly. Stuff that I taught people after that. And Bob, it's not just me that Bob taught. Dave Grennan, Jay McDowell, Ron McLean, a ton of people. Nora O'Donovan, a ton of people were on the road with Bob, and he taught all of them a lot of stuff, I'm sure.
Like how to remove a swarm of flies from a fluorescent light with hairspray?
Yeah, and hairspray and a lighter.
And a lighter?
I think I taught Bob that one, actually. So, the birthday song. Why don't you sit back and you look through and talk to people.
You want me to leave?
We don't have to leave, but you can.
No, I'm leaving. I get it.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. You're looking good. You don't look one day older than you think you should. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Won't you stay with us a little while? We're gonna eat your cake, gonna celebrate, gonna send you home in style. Are you one, are you two, are you three, are you four? Are you 98, 54? Are you 7, are you 8, are you 9 or 10? Are you trying to say you're 29 again? Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. You're looking good. You don't look even one day older than you think you should. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Won't you stay with us a little while? We're gonna eat your cake, gonna celebrate, gonna send you home in style. We're gonna eat your cake, gonna celebrate, gonna send you home in style. We're gonna eat your cake, gonna celebrate, gonna send you home in style. So that is the Beatles have a perfectly good birthday song, but we didn't have time to learn everything, so we stuck with our birthday song. That's the Painkiller Jane birthday song, written by me and my son Ben. So, Harry B. All right. Jamie, you want to keep the time for the next one?
What is it?
It's Blackbird.
Oh, you want me to
stop
there?
Yeah, please. Yeah. So this song has a lot of meaning. What the song is about is Paul McCartney was reading the paper, and he read that Arkansas had approved desegregation in the schools so that black and white kids would go to school together in the States. And so that's what the song is actually about. But it's come to mean a lot of things to a lot of people. And I've told you before how I've had a great honor of playing weddings for people, and how that's so easy and such a wonderful occasion. Unfortunately, I've also had the great honor of playing funerals for people. And so I played this for the funeral of my nephew, Sammy. Lived in Port Lambton, died of leukemia way too young. He's a teenager still, or almost, and there's a shrine to him in a cemetery in Port Lambton because he had a ton of friends, and it just meant so much to so many people. And his mom, Kerrison, asked me to play Blackbird. And I did, and I probably played it horribly, because it's a hard song to play, and especially in a moment like that. And then I also had a friend, Rock Welmo, who lived down the road from me, and he died way too young of a heart attack a few years ago, and played it at his funeral again, and I thought, okay, I'll be able to play it good this time, and no, it just kind of got to me. So try this up and out, and if I screw it up, I really don't care. Blackbird singing in the dead of the night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see all your life. You're were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of dark black night. Story, knowing it was going to be harder to play, having told that story. But that's what we do. We challenge ourselves, especially at times like this. And I'm proud of all the people who have gone on the quarantine sessions, put themselves out there playing music and taking a chance. And playing music is such a rewarding thing. It's never too late to learn. My mom started playing organ when she was, I don't know, probably 45 or I have no idea. And she's the slowest learner I ever saw in my life, I swear. But by the time, as years went past, she was playing the organ in church, was the church organist, and couldn't be more proud of her. All right, something a little bit happier. This is about a wedding. This is a wedding song in a way, Jimmy.
Okay.
Hint.
I'll take it.
This is this tells the story of John and Yoko trying to get married and having a very hard time doing so because they're so famous. This is the late 60s and whatnot. There's one particular line in here that's 50 acorns tied in a sack. And what that's about is that they had made this art project with two acorns in Coventry Garden in England. And the idea was that the acorns would grow into two oaks in love and peace and harmony, which John and Yoko were all about. But they weren't married, and so the minister at Coventry Garden wouldn't allow it to be put there, and so they relocated into a back field, and then the acorns were stolen. But what they did do is they sent two acorns to a whole pile of leaders throughout the world, like prime ministers, presidents of different countries, and asked them to plant them. And I don't know what happened, really. That's my story. That's all I got. All right. Standing in the dock at Southampton, trying to get to Holland or France. The man in the Mac said, you gotta go back, you know, he didn't even give us a chance. Christ, you know it ain't easy, you know how hard it can be. The way things are going, they're gonna crucify me. Finally made the pair in the Paris, honeymooning down by the Seine. Peter Brown called to say, said you can make it okay. You can get married in Gibraltar, near Spain. Christ, you know it ain't easy. You know how hard it can be. The way things are going, they're gonna crucify me. Oh, Paris to the Amsterdam Hilton, copying on the best for a week. Newspaper says, say what you're doing in bed. I say, we're only trying to get us some peace. Christ, you know it ain't easy. You know how hard it can be. The way things are going, they're gonna crucify me. saving up your money for a rainy day, giving all your clothes to charity. Last night though I said, oh boy, when you're dead, they won't take nothing with you but your soul. Think, made a lightning trip to Vienna, eating chocolate cake in a bag. Newspaper said she's gone to his head. They look just like two girls in drag. Christ, you know it ain't easy. You know how hard it can be. The way things are going, you're gonna crucify me. Hey, I caught the early plane back to London. 50 acorns died in the sack. A man from the press said, we wish you success. It's good to have the both of you back. Christ, you know it ain't easy. You know how hard it can be. The way things are going, they're gonna crucify me. The way things are going, they're gonna crucify me.
Go, Jimmy.
So close.
It's all good. It's all good.
My one lead guitar all night. Oh, no, I have one more.
Oh, yeah.
Shiny moments coming up.
Yeah, come on.
We are almost done. We are all, yeah, we have four more songs.
How long have we been doing this?
It's 8:21.
8:21, wow.
Well, that's good.
Well, they're Beatles songs. They're all short. They're like 2.5-3 minutes long.
They weren't known for length.
Oh, I just clicked off that. Damn.
So, yeah, we have 4 songs left. Thank you so much, everybody, for
okay,
tuning
on,
in.
On the wrong song. Hold on.
Please, please me. And I, if there's any regret, I mean, there are so many songs we can't do. And I think we've picked some really cool ones, like No Reply and... You've got to hide your love away and things like that, but we won't be doing Yesterday or Let It Be or Eleanor Rigby. So this isn't a countdown to the best songs. There's so much stuff that's that we're not going to be able to do.
Oh,
I just found one more song.
Oh,
one more song. One more song.
3 more songs. You're getting 5 right now.
Yes,
all right. Do you have any notes about this?
I'm just going to sing it and you can play it.
Okay.
Or do we both play it?
I think we both play it. Or I play it.
Yeah,
I play
you,
it.
No, you play it.
And you sing it.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Trying to see it my way. Do I have to keep on talking till I can't go on? Well, you see it your way. One risk of knowing that love may soon be gone. We can work it out. We can work it out. Think of what you're saying. You can get it wrong and still you think that it's alright. Think of what I'm saying. We can work it out and get it straight or say goodnight. We can work it out. We can work it out. Life is very short and there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend. I have always thought that it's a crime, so I will ask you once again. Try to see it my way, only time will tell if I'm right or I'm wrong. While you see it your way, there's a chance that we might fall apart before too long. We can work it out, we can work it out.
Life
is very short and there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend. I have always thought that it's a crime, so I will ask you once again. Try to see it my way, only time will tell if I'm right or I'm wrong. Why you see it your way? The risk of knowing that love may soon be gone. We can work it out. We can work it out.
think anybody noticed the page flip in the wrong two last lines?
I did, because the weird thing is, your page flips, and I made the mistake. That was just strange. All right.
No. That was funny.
We're playing out to the street, facing the street. We have a couple of people in the front yard, but I'm kind of surprised there haven't been more people walk by and think, what the heck are they doing?
Jamie, everyone's commenting how all their likes and hearts are going straight up your shorts on the phone when you look.
Nothing wrong with that.
You want to switch seats?
I can feel it.
Yeah? Good. Okay.
All right. We said we would play this slow. We are not playing the lead in this one. We did not have time to do that.
We're going to sing the bridge in our head to get the right speed.
There's like a thousand.
What's the bridge? Try to be conscious of that. Okay, here's the one. If you've been waiting for us to really make a mess of things, well, this is the one.
Oh, come on. This song is brought to you by Purell.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
See, it's not about me protecting you, it's about you protecting me.
Exactly. The shopping local, you know, drive continues more than ever. I don't know why Jamie has a Bourbon Street koozie from New Orleans, but apparently he didn't read the contract.
I'm drinking Canatera. You're fine, cool.
So on that note, retail business has opened, and they say sales have been good. They seem to be busy. They say people are idiots. Some of them say people are idiots, like, you know, just not realizing there's still a... There's still a virus to be concerned about, so just having common sense, people. But please go to your way. My friend and co-worker, Rhonda Long, was going to St. Mary's in Stratford on the weekend, so she texted a whole pile of people, put on Facebook that she was going there. She brought us back, well, beer from Junction 56, or from a job site, vodka from Junction 56, chocolate from the chocolate factory in St. Mary's, and 8 people, I think, asked her to bring stuff back. We went to Park's Blueberries a couple weeks ago, took the drive down, asked, hey, does anybody need anything while we're going? Put in your orders. So do that kind of stuff. Go out of your way to support small business. They really, really, really need it. And so do you, okay? You need it. Your kids need it. They want to have jobs. You want your kids or your grandkids to have jobs? Shop local. Amazon.com is not going to sponsor your kids' soccer team. I read that in a sign on Kingsville. Okay, so this was the first song in history to have feedback in a good way. It's the first major song to have feedback intentionally. Feedback was something you wanted to avoid at all costs, and this is probably, it's pretty early, it's probably 64. And Jimi Hendrix was a long ways off. So the song started with feedback. We're not going to do any feedback because we have no mics. And
Pete's not here.
Pete's not here. It's really hard to do feedback without without Pete, yeah. So, I forget how we start this one, Jimmy, honestly.
You start it.
Baby's good to me, you know she's happy as can be, you know she said so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. Baby said she's mine, you know she tells me all the time, you know she said so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. I'm so glad she's my little girl. She's so glad she's telling all the world that a baby buys her things, you know. He buys her diamond rings, you know. She said so. She's in love with me and I feel fine.
Guitar players out there, is you put your thumb there. You play the E string with your thumb. I asked Pete to send me...
Oh, now you play it.
Well, I know. I asked Pete to send me a video of how he plays it, because we play the song with the band. I'm the bass player. He's the drummer in Painkiller Jane. Pete Michelli is the guitar player. But Pete was too busy because his son had their fourth child... And him and Tracy had the other three kids and were taking care of them. And they haven't had little babies running around for a long time. And so he was way too busy and way too exhausted, I'm sure.
I was over there today to pick up this mic or this music stand, and he was in the middle of taking down the temporary fence around his driveway.
Okay, two more songs left. Thank you so much, everybody. This has been awesome. Absolutely gorgeous night out here. Thank you, Jimmy. Appreciate it.
Where are we?
We're doing the second last song on the list, which you probably can't see.
Oh, okay, I got it. The one that's in E?
The one that's in E.
Yep.
Let's stand up for this.
Hey,
one.
Thanks for having me.
This was
fun.
This has been a lot of fun. We've been looking forward to it. We've put a lot of work into it, so hope you appreciate it. It's a little bit tricky with the distancing to even practice and all that sort of stuff, but we have managed.
Hope we're doing the same song.
We'll find out.
Well, she was just 17. You know what I mean. And the way she looked was way beyond compare. How could I dance with another?
See, there was that one chord at the very end that I knew I didn't know, so I stopped playing.
And did I play it right?
I think so.
All right, we're down to number one, the last song.
Can I dedicate this song to my wife for our anniversary?
I was just gonna say you should have dedicated the last one.
Oh,
she wasn't. How old? She probably wasn't 17, but.
I was.
Yeah. We have Jamie's 11 years younger than me. We're best friends. Been best friends for years too. We brought you in bars. I shouldn't be telling people this, but on the road with the band, bringing this guy into bars to help us out and stuff like that when you were probably like 17 years old.
Yeah. Let's go with 17.
Yeah.
We'll go with 17. It's a lot closer than 15.
But Jamie was always mature way, way, way beyond his years. And the interesting thing, because there's going to be some people from Wyoming watching this, and Jamie and I both grew up in Wyoming, and that's how we know each other. And we had a friend named Craig Felton, a mutual friend, who passed away years and years ago. And it had the strange effect of bringing a group of people together that were younger and older. And it's hard to describe, but just a whole bunch of people that knew each other somewhat from different subsets of the small town just became best friends instantly. And it's strange how someone's death can bring a whole pile of joy if you take it the right way, and that was the case. And Jamie was around Craig's age, and you were one of the people who kind of got to know us,
little younger
guys.
Yeah, he was kind of like in the middle, and there was like the younger group and the older group.
Yeah, great guy. Can't wait to find him in heaven. I'm gonna punch him in the face. He killed himself, and not worth it. Not worth it at all. So on that happy note, we have one more song. Thank you so much, everyone. As I said, I'm going to do this again next week, but just a bit of a wind down next week, just some songs I've played over the last 8 weeks or whatever it's been. And then I'm going to take a break, get to work. And next winter, though, I could completely see doing this again if people are into it. It's been a joy. It's been an absolute pleasure and a privilege and an honor. And thank you, everyone who's been keeping watch on it.
Thanks for all the hearts up my shorts. Appreciate it. Feels great. The thumbs, not so much. The hearts, are good.
Starts with vocals.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. He's a real nowhere man, sitting in his nowhere land, making all his nowhere plans for nobody. Doesn't have a point of view, knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me?
Figures we screw this one up.
Nowhere man. Just sees what he wants to see. Nowhere man, can you see me at all? Nowhere man, little worry. Take your time, don't hurry. Leave it all to somebody else. Lends you a hand. Doesn't have a point of view. Knows not where he's going to. Isn't he a bit like you and me? Nowhere man, please.
Thanks, guys. Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers. Happy Tuesday.
Take care. See you next Tuesday. Stay safe. Be good to each other. Shop local. Do you know what to do now?
Yeah, I'm going to press erase. Bye. Thanks, Jamie. Thanks, Annette. Thanks, Aaron. And thanks, Steve. Oh, okay. I got to wait. Look at all these thanks. You're welcome. Thanks, Brian. Scott, thanks. Scott, thanks for doing Saturday nights, man. That's awesome.
Oh, thanks, Teresa. Love you. Brian,
Lena.
One of the greatest guys to play with, Brian Cox. Aaron, buddy. And, you know, I don't know Scott Maneri very well, but I know Brian Cox, and Brian says he's a great, great guy. And so I take a lot of faith in that. Hi, Jose, Lena, Tammy.
Fexy.
All they can see is you, Jimmy.
Nice to see you, man.
It's my show. It's my show, man.
Dan just texted me, I'm sorry. I don't know what that's for. Tim. Autumn says, hi, Daddy. Hi, Autumn.
Hello, Autumn. Hey, Carrie Ann.
Okay, you go now.
Okay. Hey, Tim, buddy. How you doing? Cassie. Fexy.
Wow, you got good eyesight.
Oh, your phone's so clear.
All right.
Yeah.
Everybody left. Just like that.
Cheers, guys. Take
care. Cheers.